Hey, Dr. Brown, this is Timothy Tew. I was one of your students in Wilmington, Delaware last year, 2009, in the summer. I was a kid who was dancing a lot at that girl's birthday party. Anyway, I promised you my mnemonic to remember pharyngeal arches, right? Because that's a very important subject for step one, but no one ever wants to memorize it because it's crazy. It's too crazy. So, let's begin. Let's start off by making a little table. Okay? Arch. Nerve. Artery. Mesoderm. And neural crest. Alright. Here we go. Let's label this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. So we got a blank table here, but we know we're going to fill it with very important stuff, right? Because these arches, they make some important stuff. So before we fill in the table, let's just write down what they make. They make some important stuff, right? They make some important stuff. Alright? 1, 2, 3. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's this over here? Why are 4 and 6 on the same line? Well, the stuff they make is shared. So they share this line. They're together because the stuff they make is shared. Okay? We'll see why. So it might be easier if we fill in the rest of the blanks. And then that way, you know, we can see everything, and then it'll be easier to remember. All right, so let's just fill in the blanks. All right, okay. All right, this one's cranial nerve 9. Also the laryngeal. And same for number 6. All right, now let's go with some arteries. You know, number 3 gets a little ICA action. Okay, what about number 4? That gets the aortic arch, the right subclavian. 6 gets some pulmonary, as well as the old ductus arteriosus. Okay, this is what we got so far. All right, now let's fill in this mesoderm column. Mastication, okay. Facial expression, right? Stapedius. So remember, 1 is mastication, 2 is facial expression, and stapedius. Let's move on. 4, 3 will be the style of pharyngeus. Number 4 will give rise to cricothyroid. Oh, spelled that wrong. And number 6 gives rise to everything in the larynx except the old cricothyroid. Okay. Now let's work on the neural crest. Alright, so this one, number 1 gets the maxilla, the mandible, incus, and the malleus, okay? 2 gets some stapes, some styloid, okay? 4 gets a little thyroid action in cartilage form, right? And number 6 gets other cartilage. All right? Whoa, this is a bit overwhelming, you know? We broke it down so it's nice and simple, but there's still so much for us to remember. All right, well, let's see. So these arches make some important stuff. All right? Let's circle these letters. M, S, I, and S, H. Right? Stuff. two arches, two letters.
All right. Cool.
Well, how in the world am I going to remember that the first arch gives rise to this nerve? Well, what's another name for it? It's the mandibular. Right? What does that begin with? It begins with M. M and M. And lo and behold, muscles of mastication, maxilla, mandible, and malleus. Incus, you'll have to remember that on your own, but at least we broke it down. First arch, M, right? Okay. Number two. All right. Well, let's see. What's another name for this nerve? It's the facial nerve, right? Cool. Well, that's how you remember it does the facial expressions. Facial nerve, facial expressions. What's a good facial expression? Let's smile, right? Smiling, that's a good facial expression. Well, how's that link here? Facial nerve, facial expression, smile. All right, so S for sum, S for smile, S for stapedius, S for stapes, S for styloid. Whoa, all right. How about three? Three's pretty important, right? Three makes some important things. All right. Roman numeral 9 starts with an I. ICA, I, okay. Now, what about this? Style of pharyngeus, how am I going to remember that? All right, well, what's another name for this nerve? That's the old glosso. Pharyngeal, right? Glossopharyngeal, styloid pharyngeus. Cool. That makes it a bit easier. All right, how about number four? Well, four and six come in a pair, right? They make some important stuff, and they're shared. But four is above six. Four comes first, so it always wants the first pick, right? So it picks the laryngeal nerve before six can, so it gets the superior part, right? It wants the best. Comes first, it gets the best, gives six the rest. Six gets the recurrent. What's four plus six? That's 10, right? Four plus six is 10. Four comes first, it gets the best, gives six the rest. All right, well, let's apply this over here. What's the coolest artery in the body? It's the aorta, right? So number four gets first choice. It wants the aortic arch. Six gets second dibs. So it gets stuck with the pulmonary artery instead. Okay? And four also gets the right subclavian. Six, you know, it gets the ductus arteriosus. And that's how often is that patent, you know? Most adults, you know, no ductus arteriosus, but six gets stuck with it. Okay, cool. Cricothyroid and thyroid cartilage. Those are pretty big things, right? Everyone knows these things. That's why four wants it. It wants the best, right? It wants the best. Give six the rest. Six gets everything else besides the cricothyroid in the larynx, and it gets all the other cartilage. Four wants the best, six gets the rest. Alright, cool. But that can't be everything, right? Yeah, there's some other things we have to put. So let's make another column here. For pouch. Okay, let's see. What's some important things? This one makes a little middle ear. Right, the middle ear. Here we got the inferior parathyroid. Thymus, and four gets the superior. All right. Again, one's M, so it gets everything that begins with an M, including the middle ear. Okay? Three is the eye, right? Three is eye. So three gets the inferior parathyroid. Okay, and in the thymus, that's pretty important, right? You need the thymus when you're growing up, so three gets it. But four doesn't want to be left out, you know? Even though it comes after three, it's used to getting the first choice, right? So it gets the superior parathyroid, right? It wants to be consistent. It wants the best in everything. It gets the superior parathyroid, superior laryngeal, right? And all these cool things here. All right, that's cool. But more. All right. Something else I left out here. That's the old hyoid, right? That sounds familiar, right? The hyoid. What's the hyoid? You know, you got the lesser horn, you got the greater horn, you got the lower body, you got the upper body. How can you remember that? All right, well, two and three give rise to those parts of the hyoid, right? But which ones? Right? You got the lesser horn, upper body, right? And you got the greater horn and the lower body. Okay, how do you remember that? Well, let's see. Two. Everyone can draw two, right? Well, what's the first part of drawing the two? You start out with this, right? Well, what happens when you do that? That kind of looks like a breast, right? That looks like some upper body action. And what's the next part of the two? This part. But that kind of looks like a horn, right? So it gets the upper body and the lesser horn. Lesser because it's below. All right. How about three? There's no way you can make the three into the greater horn and the lower body, right? Well, just rotate it. Okay, so now you got the three rotated. And that kind of looks like that some lower body, you know? Everyone likes some lower body. So then you can just add some horns too if you want, right? And they're greater horns because they're above. Right? Lower body, greater horns. Upper body, lesser horns. So, the two gets the upper body, lesser horns. Three gets lower body, greater horns. See, you don't even have to be able to read my handwriting. You know? You don't even have to be able to read. You just need to be able to draw. You know? So, you can't read that. It's okay, because you remember that two becomes upper body, lesser horn, and three becomes lower body and greater horn. All right. Well, that might seem complete, but I got one more thing for you, okay? Facial nerve. What else does that innervate? Well, that's the... Let's see... Right? This innervates the submandibular and sublingual gland. Right? Both of these begin with S. Right? Both of these begin with S. And we know so do smiles, tapetius, stapes, and styloid. Right? So here we go. All you need to remember is that these pharyngeal arches make some important stuff. So there's my mnemonic, Dr. Barone. I hope you found it, you know, nice and easy to follow. I hope you find it useful and that you can show it to your students. It helped me remember these things. Hopefully it can help others remember these. Feel free to use it in your review sessions. And if you have room in your book, you know, you can throw it in there. I'd love that. Just give me a little credit, you know, that'd be good. But just wanted to give back because you know, your mnemonics helped me out a lot. So I just wanted to give back to you. All right, so just in case you missed anything, okay, just want to make sure you're able to get everything. And there we go. Remember these, and you're golden. Thanks.